Earlier in this lab, we talked about creating a group to help manage and collaborate on content that's in Power BI. And if you set up an Office 365 group to do that, there's another good use of it. If you're using OneDrive for business, when you put files in there like Excel files or Power BI desktop files, you can use your Office 365 groups to collaborate and share on that as well. Let me show you a little bit more detail. I've got a OneDrive here with a couple of files uploaded. I've got an Excel file, and this Van Arsdale sales report is the Power BI desktop file that I uploaded. Now, because they're stored on OneDrive, I get great things like version control and management and history of all of these files. So I can see if people make updates to them, make changes to those files, I can see when they were updated, who modified it, et cetera, et cetera. Now, I could use an Office 365 group here as well by saying, okay, I want to share this file either with individuals or invite Office 365 groups. That way, many people can work on the same Power BI files or Excel files. So that's fine getting them into OneDrive and having one place to store it, but what about pushing that thing, that content into Power BI? Well, once you log into the Power BI site, if you go to Get Data, I can come and choose to connect to a file. That's what we're connecting to here. But this time we're connecting to a file in OneDrive for Business. When I do that, I see the files that are available for me. I've got that Excel file, and we'll see in one of the other labs a little bit more about how you can manage Excel content. But for now, let's focus on the PBIX file here. This is the Power BI desktop file. When I click this and choose Connect, it'll actually import the content from that file into my Power BI space. It'll go and create a data set and a report based on any of the pages that are in that file. So I can see over on the left-hand side is the data set and the report that's just been created. Now, the great thing is that whenever somebody goes and makes a change to that file on the OneDrive, either by republishing it from, re-uploading it from their computer or going to the website and re-uploading it there, any changes will get automatically reflected and refreshed into the Power BI environment as well. So any changes to the reports or refreshes to the data will get picked up by OneDrive and get pushed into the Power BI as well. And you'll still see it through that version history. So this is really a sort of a best practice for how you can use OneDrive for Business and Office 365 groups to manage and collaborate amongst a group of people on Power BI content.